Good morning and welcome to Weekends with Whitney on what is another soggy day across South Louisiana. I tell you, between the rain and the warmer temperatures, it really feels like spring, yet we're still in the dead of winter. So we have a few things to brighten up your day. The first, a woman whose passion propelled her to sink her life savings into a sinkhole. Well, only partly. Why she's showing the world the plight of the people affected by the Bayou Corne sinkhole. Then we get to the heart of the matter on heart disease and new innovative ways to protect your heart, your brain, and nearly everything else in your body. Then Dr. Nick shows us a fun way to bring more intimacy into our relationships. But first, have you ever been so passionate about something that you would sink your life savings into it, sell your home, even take out every penny in your 401k? Well, you're about to meet the woman who did just that. Pictures are shocking. The scene, astounding. The impact, devastating. This is the Bayou Corne sinkhole. It devoured this Assumption Parish town in unimaginable ways. It's a story Victoria Green says she had to tell.
That's the only way that people will understand what has happened and never forget.
It would be Victoria's first feature film, a gutsy move for a woman whose career was marketing. That shifted 6 years ago when she was cast as an extra in the movie Pitch Perfect, filming in Baton Rouge.
Shorty, get down, good Lord. Woo! Baby got 'em open all over town.
First day on the set, I said, this is it. And I said, my life will forever be changed.
She produced a few short films, but the last 4 years, she's devoted her life and life savings into making Forgotten Bayou.
You put all your money in this. You took out your retirement.
Some people would call me very foolish, yes. Just about everything I have is in this film.
That's passionate.
Well, I only know how to do things right. And it was very important to finish this film for Bayou Corne, for the community members that put so much faith in me to tell their story.
One of those community members, Dennis Landry, saw a special showing of the movie recently at Celtic Studios.
I think the film was great. I think it exceeds my expectations, and my expectations were high. I think she was very honest with the story. I think she's portrayed all sides of the story.
Victoria did so without taking sides either.
The film is very neutral.
Is it?
It's very neutral.
Was it hard to be neutral?
What we did, what we chose to do, is tell this story by those individuals featured in the film. Some people will have different takes on it. Some people will think Texas Brine did the right thing. Some people will think, well, they weren't fair. I let each individual come to their own conclusion. I let them tell the story. I don't tell you what to think.
Many residents, like Talisa Domacreature, were skeptical of Victoria initially.
Because I did not trust her at first. And I was running Bayou Corne Cinco page on Facebook. She was running forgotten Bayou page, and I was watching her page like a hawk, just that she didn't say anything that wasn't true. Because my thing all along was I wanted people to stay. And I didn't want people to hear things that wasn't true that was scaring them off.
Most of the 350 residents were scared off anyway. Talisa and Dennis are two of only a handful left. Others may be afraid of the frequent methane gas bubbles, but as you can see, Talisa's not.
I'm almost touching the water where they're coming up. And I didn't blow up. Imagine that.
As soon as it hits the air, it dissipates. So I knew it wasn't floating around in the air like this big black cloud.
Just the other day, I went back to the original bubble site, the bubble site my wife and I first discovered, May 30th, 2012. That bubble site is still there. It's not nearly as strong as what it was at one time, but it is still there, believe it or not. So I'm hoping that in my lifetime, I'll see the bubbling disappear, but I'm not real optimistic that we will. I think gas is still trapped down there.
Trapped when the salt dome collapsed and created this giant sinkhole that's now grown from 2 acres to more than 35.
This sinkhole has never occurred. Anything like this has. This is an unprecedented event. There's never been a sinkhole like this ever in the history of the world.
In Forgotten Bayou, you're transported into the world of these homeowners whose lives were sinking like the land around them. Their individual journeys are as striking as the area's beauty Victoria captures on film.
You really got to know them and you empathize with them that way. Mm-hmm. It's more than just a number. You know, it's not how many families, it's these are real people.
Author and TV anchor Leo Honeycutt says the film's thoroughness is astounding.
This is a situation where, you know, it tells you the entire, more than you ever dreamed about the story, but it's in such an enlightening way to where you feel it as if you were there.
Forgotten Bayou's been selected to screen at 3 film festivals so far, including the Santa Fe Film Festival.
Every time you go to a film festival, there are opportunities for distribution. Everybody wants distribution. So there's iTunes, there's Netflix, there's Amazon, there's network television, there's PBS. So hopefully we'll be in those avenues later in 2017 and 2018.
As the story of Bayou Corne travels the country, Dennis says he'll still be right here.
I love living on the bayou, and I hope to spend the rest of my days right there on a beautiful bayou.
A bayou many could never forget. And if you would like to see the movie Forgotten Bayou, the next screening will be 1 week from today, next Sunday, 2 o'clock, for the Cinema on the Bayou Film Festival. It's in Lafayette at the Acadiana Center for the Arts. Tickets are $6.50. And still to come, a revolutionary plan to prevent heart disease, stroke, and diabetes, and how you can meet the doctor behind it. Then if you're tired of conversations that only scratch the surface, Dr. Nick has some new tools to help us grow deeper and stronger relationships with everyone in our lives as Weekends with Whitney continues.
Who says an old dog can't learn new tricks?
Do you want to learn how to inspire?
Learn to fly?
Or learn how to drive?
Take a run around this park.
Or this park.
Or this park.
And we'll teach you how to dance.
And reach for the sky.
No matter your age, Breck offers classes to keep you moving, learning, and having fun.
Visit Breck.org and see how together we've made Breck better than imagined.
Welcome back to Weekends with Whitney. Now we're going to get down to the heart of the matter. Heart disease affects nearly all of us. But did you know there are some simple lifestyle changes that you can make to decrease your chances of having a heart attack by nearly 800%? Simple pleasures like getting a good night's sleep, the joy of a good laugh, eating chocolate, even brushing your teeth, all keep your beating heart from turning into a ticking time bomb. Dr. Cherie LeBlanc is one of 900 doctors across the country and the only one in Baton Rouge now offering a revolutionary plan that could add more than 16 years to your life.
This is more focused on vascular disease, which is heart attack and stroke, but it's also dementia, it's heart failure, it's erectile dysfunction, it's macular degeneration. It's all of those things are still diseases of the vascular system. We just think of the heart attack and stroke, of course, because that's what can suddenly kill someone.
It's called the bile donating method. Dr. LeBlanc spent the last 2 years training in it to bring it to Baton Rouge.
We can actually see regression of disease with this type of treatment protocol.
It involves specialized tests that range from genetic testing to insulin resistance.
Insulin resistance is something that is really not aggressively checked for or treated. Studies have shown it's present in 70% of people who have heart attacks and strokes.
Moreover, 6 out of 10 people who've had a heart attack never knew they were at risk. For women, Dr. LeBlanc says, there are often little known signs to watch for.
What would some of those red flags be?
For women, gestational diabetes, preeclampsia, so things that happened maybe years ago during childbearing years. It can be migraine headaches. It can be polycystic ovarian disease. It could be facial hair growth can actually be a concerning symptom.
Dr. LeBlanc spends 10 to 12 hours studying her patient's test results. After that, she spends 4 hours with the patient to explain it and tailor an individual plan.
Not everyone is the same. It's nice to have studies that look at 30,000 patients, but when I'm sitting across from you, you want to know what is specific for you, taking into consideration all the testing. And so that's what we do, is we come up with a personalized plan, and that takes time.
Method co-founder and author of Beat the Heart Attack Gene, Dr. Bradley Bale, will be in our capital city this week to help save lives.
He's spoken all over the world. He has patients from all over the world that seek his advice. And he's going to be here in Baton Rouge giving a free seminar on exactly what he does. And this is just probably a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to hear him speak. So I would encourage anyone, if you're in hearing distance, to make it out to his talk.
Dr. Bale is offering a free seminar coming up this Thursday night, 6:30 to 7:30 at the Dunham School in their Chapel Hall. If you can't make that, you may want to pick up the book, Beat the Heart Attack Gene. And still to come, Dr. Nick shares some fun ways to grow closer to everyone in your life as Weekends with Whitney continues.
Maggio, the only way to go. Maggio Buick GMC, your satisfaction's our specialty. We really deliver on Fault River here in New Roads. Small town atmosphere, legendary service for over 60 years. Maggio, the only way to go. The only way to go, that's Maggio.
9-time winner of the prestigious Buick GMC Mark of Excellence Award. I know it's been more than a month since the holidays wrapped up, but around your Christmas table or perhaps your Thanksgiving table, what kind of conversations did you have? Well, we hope nobody threw the mashed potatoes, but Dr. Nick is here to share some ways that we can share more of ourselves and yet kind of dig a little bit deeper.
And have fun doing it.
And it doesn't cost money.
And it doesn't cost money. Yeah.
Yeah, we were saying when we were talking about this, darn, we should have done this back in October or November.
But it's really a simple but powerful way of connecting people. Let me tell you how I came to this, because I don't think it's original. I think anybody would say.
And it's a game, by the way.
It's a game. I just remember a number of years ago, mm-hmm. I took my nieces and nephews, I'm guessing maybe four of them, to see a movie.
Okay.
So we got out of the movie and we were in the car, and I wanted to talk about the movie. And I didn't know how I was going to get them to talk about the movie, because I wanted to hear their experiences. Okay. And I said, why don't we play a little game? I'll start. Tell me one thing that really struck you in this movie, that you really, really liked. It just like had an impact on you. And if you don't have one, because it may take you a few minutes to think, just say pass. And when you have stated what it was, say pass.
Okay.
So that the next person will know it's his or her turn. So I started it and I said, I really was impacted by this. And one of the nephews, who I think was 13, said, pass. So I went to the next one and she said something. And then I think it was three girls. Then she said something, pass. She said something. And they said, oh, that's interesting. And I said, oh, no, we're just getting started. Now I'm going to tell you something else that struck me. And they said, we've already given an answer. I said, one thing in a 2-hour movie? Surely not. Surely not. And of course, the smart aleck one said, don't call me Shirley. So I said another one, got to the adolescent. Guess what?
What?
He didn't pass. Oh. He now wanted to play. Who wants to sit on the sidelines?
Nobody.
Everybody wants to play.
Yeah.
It just took a little bit to get him in, and then he said something. And what happens is you start, I call it popcorn. You're popping. And one thing that somebody else says makes somebody think of something else, or they could repeat it. Sure. They could say, that struck me too, mm-hmm. pass. But the idea is that everybody is talking from their experience, Whitney. Mm. And then you've got this incredible reflection. Not only a game, but they're reflecting on what they experienced. Now think about that at the dinner table, if there ever is one. or and you're in the car going to pick up the fast food. What was something that struck you today in school? What was something that was challenging for you today? And you just kind of play the game. Doesn't it, do you see how much fun it is?
Well, I see how much better you get to know someone.
And you get to know someone.
And perhaps they get to know themselves better. I did feel that, right? I didn't
Whitney,
realize it, but I...
Absolutely. And you notice, no conversation. You can't pop in and say, oh, what? That kid said what to you? That's no fair.
Okay.
It's her experience. It's her experience. You're not trying to correct or say, oh, well, that was stupid. I didn't like that. No.
Or how about you shouldn't feel that way.
Or you shouldn't feel that way. Or I don't know why in the world you would have thought that. It's letting each person be in their own body.
Mm-hmm.
Whitney, it's powerful. I know I get excited about it because I think it's so much fun.
Yeah.
And it costs nothing. And it's a way to communicate other than drama or how was school? Fine.
Oh, that makes me bananas.
Did you like that movie? It was okay.
What'd you like about it? I don't know. What didn't you like about it?
I don't know. So you're pushing.
Enough.
And do you hear? You're pushing for specific. What was just one thing that jumped out? You know, or who did you really like in it? Or how, you know, what made your day so special? Or how did you get through this?
Right.
Because you woke up this morning not feeling good.
Mm-hmm. You know, when I think of, and we're talking
so
about.
Many questions
so
you could
many.
Ask. So many questions
well,
you could ask.
And I'm thinking about at a family gathering or a dinner party
yes.
or whatever, that you could always say, to what this year and you know you just start really broad like
what
one thing
year?
This year did you learn or what take what away or was or, really challenging
or what one thing this year that you changed
I
stopped drinking and I've been going to 12-step meetings. Nobody's going to respond. It's just sharing.
Yeah.
Or I've made a decision that I don't think I've screamed in 6 months at my kids. It doesn't have to be heavy, but it can be very, very revealing.
Yeah.
It's vulnerable when you're laughing. You're like thinking some families couldn't do it.
No, I'm thinking of what my daughter said to me this morning.
Can you share it?
I can. So she said, Mom, so what are you changing for the new year? And I said, well, you know, I've started on this huge cleaning thing. I've spent 24 hours in her room, like organizing and stuff. Really should have started in mine, I know, but I knew that hers was not going to get done. And I said, and you've seen that. And she said, I have an idea. How about
you'll be on time. And I said, oh, that's a big one.
Oh, Whitney.
I know, right?
And that's great.
She said, well, you can start with just breakfast.
That is great.
Having breakfast ready when they
that
come
is
in.
Great.
Already.
That is great. And now imagine how you could make that a game where you've got the whole family in the room and saying, okay, everybody gets to say one thing that they wish somebody else in the family might consider doing. Yeah. But you could also say to her, would you consider making your bed every day?
Right.
Yeah. Or you know, picking your clothes out before the night before. I mean, you can really make it again. The main thing is that it cannot be judgmental.
Right.
It can't be, I'm going to tell you what you should be experiencing. That ruins it.
Yeah.
But I love it.
I did too. Well, and you know, and then you'll love my response too. I said, you know, hey, that's big. I don't know if that's like, oof, all year long. I said, but perhaps I'll give up being tardy for Lent. It's a little more contained, doable, maybe. She laughed.
Quick story. My mother smoked all her life. Uh-huh. Lent came and she said, I'm going to spend 40 days not smoking. She never picked up another cigarette.
Wow.
Do it.
You're right. And you know, we have Lent coming up.
Because if you can do it for 40 days, you can do it for 400.
Yeah. Amen for that. You're so
You can
right.
do it.
Yeah. And I'm going to play that
but
game.
But that's the power of the game. Even though it wasn't necessarily formal, you had a communication. I still think that it would have been neat if y'all had said, let's talk about some things we're going to change. And
yes.
You might have even said, I'm going to work on being on time, which really would have been great.
I know. I did say. I thought
you
I was going to be about being tardy for Lent.
Yeah, but I love that you're procrastinating. I mean, Lent's a little bit down the road.
I was trying not to be a liar either.
You've got to get yourself ready.
It's been 50 years of this. Are you kidding me?
So you're going to not be on time being on time yet. But maybe it by Lent.
I'll have time.
Play the game. Play it in the car. Play it at a restaurant. Play it at home when you're sitting around.
Yeah.
It's fun.
Yeah.
And it's reflective of life.
And each other. I love it. Great. Thanks so much.
Bye-bye, everyone.
Thanks for sharing your game. More Weekends with Whitney after this. Game on.
Game on.
In games without frontiers, or without tears.
Atlas Foundation Repair, fixing your foundation problems for more than 30 years while preserving and protecting your trees.
Thanks for sharing part of your Sunday with us here on Weekends with Whitney. Hope to see you back here again next week. Until then, you can follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram, or head to my YouTube channel, Weekends with Whitney, or my website, weekendswithwhitney.net. This time last Sunday, the marathon was well underway. Well, we took to the air with the drone to bring you some beautiful shots. It was a real foggy start to the morning, and that lended itself to some magical pictures. Enjoy. We'll be right back.
on through. Gotta send my love down to Baton Rouge. Hurry up, won't you put her on the line? Gotta talk to the girl just one more time. Samantha, dear.